the Tesla Model S, an all-electric sedan that is perhaps one of the most awaited electric cars ever. In the 3 years since Tesla first announced the car, excitement has grown and thousands have been reserved sight unseen. Driving it near the company's headquarters in Palo Alto, California recently, it proved to be a real head-turner, and now the first production models are being delivered to customers. The basic design is about as simple as it gets. It's really no more than a battery and a motor. There are a couple of other bits to control the air conditioning and braking, but it's probably less complicated than you might expect. But don't let that fool you. This is a really high-tech car. Fun with the Model S begins getting into it. The door handles are recessed, but touch them and they glide out to allow entry. One of the most impressive features on the inside of the car is a 17-inch flat panel display that takes up most of the center console. It can be used to set and tweak the drive mode, monitor data from sensors throughout the vehicle, run the air conditioning and interior lighting, adjust the audio system. Well, you get the idea. It also has a built-in web browser that forms the basis of the Google navigation system and lets you browse real websites. The basic model costs just under $50,000, and the one I'm about to drive close to $100,000, so it was with a little nervousness that I got into the driver's seat. So I've had the instruction on how to drive the car. Let's see how it goes. Pull this down to put it into drive. Take my foot off the brake and just apply the accelerator, and off we go. The car can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles an hour in 4.4 seconds. Not something I could test, but it was very responsive. The car felt solid cornering the windy roads near Tesla's headquarters, where driving was a lot of fun. The car employs a regenerative braking system, which uses energy created when it slows down to recharge the battery. The car starts slowing down as soon as you take your foot off the accelerator, so that makes it very easy to drive. It's almost a little like a video game. The accelerator provides much more speed control than a conventional gasoline car. There's none of the coasting you might be used to. In fact, I only needed to use the brake when coming to a stop at intersections. Going around these corners and adjusting the speed with the accelerator, the car is incredibly smooth on the road. It's a pleasure to drive. Recharging is as simple as plugging it in. A light pulses fast to steady to indicate the status. The distance that can be traveled depends on the battery installed, and when driving at 55 miles per hour, it ranges from 160 miles with a 40 kilowatt hour battery to 300 miles with an 85 kilowatt hour battery.
Technology in the batteries is constantly improving. It's a pretty exciting thing from a car point of view. Today we're just at a tipping point where it's actually for the first time ever possible to build an electric vehicle that has a range similar to a gasoline vehicle. So this car has 300 miles of range, which was never possible before. And you know, the lithium batteries are getting better, maybe 7 or 8% every year. A little bit more energy, more range. And you know, also the cost is improving. So it's a very exciting time. And you know, vehicles that we'll build 10 years from now, you know, could have potentially almost twice the range of today, or a battery pack that weighed half as much as the battery packs we have today.
Several US states are building electric car charging stations, and Tesla is proposing a series of supercharging stations that will be able to recharge to half capacity in 30 minutes. But for most drivers, the 300 miles should be enough for all but the longest days behind the wheel. In Palo Alto, this is Martin Williams, IDG News Service.